Hello and welcome to all my dear children. A very good pleasant morning. Welcome to English online class today. Today we are going to start with a new lesson from your book Communicate with Cambridge, course book 8, page number 10. The name of the chapter, we will start from section B, unit 1. Section B, Children of India, author Ruskin Bond, page number 10. Right? Children, this chapter, this lesson, we will be learning that how blessed we are in comparison to the children of living in the rural areas, villages, right? Children of India means, the author is saying that the children of India means the whole, in India the children who stays in India, how they live their life. What is the difference between the children staying in the cities and students staying in the villages, rural areas? Correct? Education is the right of every children. But how many of them are fortunate to get the education? Sometimes children feel education to be a burden, but education is the way, is the way to make the life. Today we will be learning that how the children of villages, they go to school, how much they take pain and struggle to go to school. Right? Today I will be giving you the only introduction of the chapter. Correct? Now, please, I request everyone to kindly go through this video very carefully. Right? Now, as I told you, the name of the chapter is from Unit 1, Section B, Children of India, by Ruskin Bond. Now, in this story, there are three main characters. Right? There are three main characters of the story. First is Ruskin Bond, the author of the story, the one who has written the story. He himself is there in the story. Second character is Ranbir, a child of 10 years old boy. Third character, Bindra, 14 years old boy. So they are brothers and sisters. Right? They live in a rural area. Here, Ruskin Bond, every day, through his window, he watches, he sees that how the children of the rural areas, the Ranbir and his friend and other children, how they go to school, how they reach. Their school is not nearby, it's very far, miles. They don't have the school transport. Here I will show you the picture. Here you can see children, that how they are, how much pain they are taking, how much struggle they are taking to reach the school, to reach to their school. And how blessed we are that our school bus come to our doorstep and drop us to the doorstep. Are we not fortunate? Are we not lucky? So for that we need to thank our parents, our God Almighty, who has blessed us with such a good life. Right? When you come to school, or when you see, before you get up, your mother is already in the kitchen and preparing everything for you. A good, delicious tiffin, packed in a tiffin bag. So you're very fortunate, lucky and blessed. On the same hand, the children who stay in rural areas, they are not so fortunate. They have to go to school by themselves. They have, after coming to school, they also help their parents, their mother, their father in their field, the dairy, and other places in the market. Right? Now, in this chapter, what are the learning objectives we have? We will see. We will read the story and understand the difference in the education and the facilities received by the children from different society, that is urban and rural. Children staying in urban area, children staying in rural area. But what we'll learn, we'll learn the difference, what is the difference in the education received by the children from different society in India. Second objective, what we learn, we will learn how blessed we are. The Almighty has blessed us with such a good life in the city, and how unfortunate, not so lucky, are the others whom education are going to school are daily struggles. Walking miles, they don't have the school transport. Their shoes are torn. They are wearing same shoes for years, same bags for years. And every year we change our bag, our shoes, right? We get pocket money at home from our parents. Even do they get? No. We'll compare it with one's own life. Just compare your life with these children who are working outside in the hotels, in the construction field. They are working and they are going to school also. Just compare your life. Then you will be saying, thanks God for giving such a wonderful life to me. And we learn to count the blessings. That is indefinite. Correct? So here the children of India, the author Ruskin Bond says that he shows the differentiate between children staying in cities and children staying in villages. Cities children are fortunate because their school infrastructure is well built up. You come to school, you have a smart class, you have labs, you have a school field, you have auditorium, you have library, so many facilities in the schools have. But children going to the ordinary school or rural children going to schools, they don't have such a good infrastructure. Second, the children coming to urban areas, even their infrastructure, school having ACs, fans, well-maintained doors, windows, and everything is well-maintained. And other children, those going in rural areas, they are going to the government schools, their infrastructure is very low, very, very, very poor. Right? Then we have the infrastructure. Then the teaching quality. There's a big difference. Right? Then the transport. Is there a difference, right? So here, children of India means the author says that when he watches every day the rural area children going to school, they have to climb the mountain, the hills, and get down and cross the field, okay, and reach, go miles to the school. Again, coming back same way. Right? This is the chapter of children of India. I gave you the introduction part of the what the author wants to say. We will be continuing with the story. I will be telling you the summary of the story again in the next class. Today I am just giving you this video. Watch very carefully. Please watch very carefully at the children of India this video and understand the difference between children staying in the urban and children staying in the rural. So now I want to show you one more picture. Here you can see children, the picture over here. See this child. This children was, they have the transport facility, they can go to school by bus, come to school by, and this is how they were walking. They don't have school facilities, buses. So we are blessed to have such a good life. So we should thank our parents and our Almighty for giving such a good life. Here you can see another picture, the girl helping her mother in the field. And even though she goes to school also. This is what life is. Right? I hope you have understood this introduction part. So, before ending this end class, I just want to tell you the characters again. Ruskin Bond, the author himself, is there. He watches every day. He has seen the struggles of the children of the villagers going to school. Ranbir, a 10-year boy who's a very ambitious boy who wants to live a life. Okay, who wants to fulfill all his ambition, all his life. Okay, and then the sister of Ranbir is Indra. She's a girl of 14 years old. And they come from a very poor family. Their parents are farmers. Okay. Right? So we are and this is the learning objective, the difference that between the urban and rural areas. Second objective, we learn how blessed are children staying in cities, how unfortunate are students those who stay in villages, and compare with one's own life. We compare our life with them, then we'll really thank to God and to ourselves that such a good life we have got. And we will learn to count blessings, how blessed we are to have such a wonderful life. So those who have textbook, they can read that story right now, and next class we will continue more on this. So till then, stay home, stay safe, have a good day. God bless you all. Thank you.